Hey friends, Sonic Toast here. Welcome to my live boxing amiibo video. This is tough for me because I'm boxing all my amiibos back into their original plastic bubbles, and they're going to be going into boxes because I'm moving, is the truth. I'm moving, so I gotta get all my stuff all packed up, and yeah, they're all gonna be boxed up. I'm just gonna miss them. I'm going to miss them very much until I'm into my new house and I'll get my new office all set up, and I'll eventually get to unbox all the amiibos again and set them up all nicely, and that'll be fun. But this is gonna be a task and a half just getting them all boxed up, so I thought it'd be more fun if I could do this with you here. We could do it together and just talk about all the fun times we've had with these amiibos and in this office and all this fun stuff. Let me take you all on a quick tour really quick, because see, the amiibos are kind of in a mess, so I've kind of packed up a lot of the stuff. These are the only three amiibos I actually have, like, in the box. Wedding Mario and Wedding Peach, and then regular Bowser. So, Wedding Mario and Wedding Peach were a wedding gift from a friend of mine for my wedding. It was just in February. Of course, I already had Wedding Mario and Wedding Peach, but it was still a very nice gesture, so got those. The reason why I have Bowser still in the box is because here is my Bowser, the exact same Bowser, but he has a spike missing on his shell, and I have no idea when that happened, or where it went, or why. But yeah, and then I saw this one online. It was on sale in a lot, like a sale lot. It was this and a Toad Wii remote with the Wii Motion Plus all built in, the Toad one. So they were together, and it was like $24 for a Wiimote and this Bowser. I was like, yeah, sure, I'll definitely buy that. It was Crazy Bears. So yeah, that was nice. So, wow, a lot of people have joined in. For those of you who are just joining us, yeah, so I am in the process of boxing up all of these amiibos because they are going to be going into storage for the next, I don't know how long, because I am moving, and this is like the hardest part, is saying goodbye to the amiibos. But yeah, they're going to be going into storage, and when I do get into my new house, I'll have a new office, set it up nicely, and we'll be able to unbox all these amazing amiibos again and get them looking all nice. You can see over here, a lot of my stuff is packed up. Sonic plushies, like half of them are packed up. My video game collection, well, a lot of them are gone. Action figures, all missing. Oh, here's the brand new Fire Mario and Yellow Yoshi. Just got those at Walmart today, so I won't be able to do an unboxing video of them for a while because just so busy right now getting everything all boxed up. So yeah, and my office is just a complete mess right now with stuff everywhere. So that is what's going on in my life. So before we get too far into this, why don't we take a couple comments? Let's see. Goku Ketchum's here. He says, good luck with the move. Thank you, Goku Ketchum. It's always a pleasure having you here. What does Dia Noville say? I haven't seen the channel in a while. This channel I was my childhood. Thanks for the memories, Sonic Toast. You're very welcome. I've been getting that a lot lately. My channel was your childhood. And that's really cool for me because I've been on YouTube for, 13 years, maybe 14 years. And, yeah, I guess all the small children who once watch my channel are grown up now, and I think that's cool that I was able to be there along, you know, along the ride for your childhood, be part of your growing up. That was fun. Anyway, so we're doing the first one. Luckily, I did label most of these when I unboxed them. So this says Pokemon Trainer. So let's go ahead and we will, they're dusty. Dusty, dusty amiibos. All right. See if I can get the Pokemon Trainer in just right. And there we go. There's an amiibo back. All right. Put him right up there. And this is going along swimmingly. Second one, this is Daisy. This is the first one I thought that I grabbed. You may have seen me trying to stick Daisy into the wrong the wrong case, but here is Daisy. And no way we're getting through all these today, but you know, I just thought it'd be fun just to box these up and see how you guys are all doing, because we haven't done a live stream in a while. Let's see. Whoops, I don't mean to put my finger into the camera. Let's see. Double Bacon Cheeseburger says, that's actually a smart idea, labeling the packages. Thank you, Double Bacon Cheeseburger. And Sonic Adventure says, what's going on here? I just joined Sonic Adventure. So I have seen some comments, people worried, saying I'm selling my amiibos or getting rid of them. No, I'm not doing that. I'm moving to a new house. So I'm packing up my whole office, and as I was getting ready to pack up the amiibos, I just thought it'd be fun to do this stream and, you know, be able to chat with you guys while we do this. Let's see what Kirby says. User Kirby says, Sonic Toast, do you miss the Wii Shop channel, and do you wish Nintendo kept the virtual console service? No, I don't. I like the new Switch online mode that has the, how you get all those Super Nintendo games and NES games, and every couple months they add more and more. I like that a lot better, because you get a lot of games instead of just a couple of games that you buy here and there. So the Wii Shop channel was innovative. It was fun at the time, but I think we have better things now. So I don't miss it. Let's see, what does Connor Rentz say? Wow, I remember seeing a video of you unpacking Mario and Sonic figures years ago, which actually helped me pack up stuff when I first moved. Cool! I'm glad I was able to help you like that. You know what I did today? I packed up a bunch of my consoles, like, because I have the original boxes of most of my consoles, so that was weird, trying to fit them all back into the styrofoam and the cardboard and the wires and everything. That was weird. Tom Nook. There we go. We've got three. At this rate, if we're doing all of them tonight, it would take a really long time to get them all. I have a little cough. To get them all back in their boxes. All right. So, who are we going to do next? Let's see. This one. This belongs to Incineroar. All right. I guess you can definitely see how the newer characters were on the top of the box, top of the pile. So, that's why you had Pokemon Trainer and Daisy and now Incineroar. All right. Incineroar back in there. All right. I feel like Bowser's Castle is going to be in the way. I don't know if any of you guys knew this, but because I'd show this display a lot in my videos whenever we unbox an amiibo. And behind Bowser's Castle was actually the original NES box. And that had a whole bunch of stuff on top of it. So that's why I had to take everything down, because I had to take that out to put my NES away. And so, let's pull Bowser's Castle out of here. Dusty. I hate dust. It is the worst. Oh, Ian Sweeney's here. He says, hey, Sonic Toast. Hey, Ian Sweeney. It's good to see you. And Ethan Bates is here. He says, you should make a custom amiibo display base. Maybe theme like a battle for Smash. That's a cool idea, too. Definitely. I'm just putting Bowser's Castle on the floor right here. I do have this one Smash battle. I can't. It's easier to just bring this over here. So it's the one that's designed to look like the battlefield from Smash Brothers. And so that's a pretty cool one that they made. I think I still have the package for that one too. I think it was with all my amiibo packages. Here it is in Japanese. So I'll have to end up folding that up and putting that away too. Oh, the fun. Yeah. And yes, I'm wearing my Pac-Man 40th anniversary shirt. Anyway, who's next? Oh, okay. This is not an amiibo box. This is a Totaku box. I guess we're going to do Totaku Knuckles next, because it was next in line there. So, Totaku Knuckles. You know, speaking of Totakus, let's see. Got him. I'm back. Here's Totaku Knuckles. What was it? Oh, yeah, I got a Totaku recently I should show you all. Where is it? Everything is such a mess right now because just been trying to pack. Yeah, I still keep getting more stuff because I guess I'm weird like that where I just always buy everything that has Sonic or Mario's faces on it. There. And here. It's always good to keep the original boxes just in case you end up moving, because these things work just fine. My Disney Infinity figures, I did not keep their original boxes, and packing them up was a nightmare. Wrapping them up in all kinds of bubble wrap and newspaper and everything, just trying to make sure they're protected. And who knows how many of them are broken already, just from being all in a box together. And let's see. Oh, here's a good question from Blue Boy the Nerd. He says, are you considering the Lego Mario sets? I'm considering the Mario figure because I think it's cool with the voice and the expressions and stuff. But those Mario sets, I'm afraid I'm completely going to pass on the Lego Mario sets. They look interesting. They look cool. But I've never been too into Lego. And Lego is expensive. Not saying the stuff I buy isn't expensive. But, like, I'm just not very passionate about Lego. And so I just don't think I see myself starting to collect the Mario Lego sets. Because I can see them just ending up all in a box. And I did the Mario Kinect sets for quite a while, and I seem to like those better. I wonder if they're going to keep doing those. But yeah, no plans to do the Mario Lego sets right now. Anyway, where was the thing I wanted to show you guys? Oh, I think I found it. Here we go. Nope, this is not it. What is this? Oh, that's weird. As my Sonic Blu-ray, the Sonic movie. I was just looking for this last night because I was packing up all my movies last night, and I said, hey, where's the Sonic movie? I had no idea where it was, and apparently it was right here in my office in a Target bag for some reason. That is bizarre. Where is it? Ah. I almost tripped on amiibo boxes. Anyway, here we are, friends. So I thought this was cool. Speaking of Totakus, I was just at GameStop yesterday, and I got this Coco Bandicoot, who was on clearance for only $3.97. I thought that was cool. There's another one. It was, they had Lara Croft in her, like, classic outfit from the old Tomb Raider games. I'm like, oh, maybe I'll get that one too. But that one was $12. And it was on clearance. I'm like, oh, that's not a very good clearance price. No. So I only got this one, Coco Bandicoot. So that was, I thought that was pretty cool. A good price. And I also got this. This was a Lapras action figure from Pokemon, also on clearance for $3.97. So I was happy about that one too, because I do like these Pokemon action figures. Who makes these again? I know we've done unboxings of these before. I actually have an unboxing that I haven't edited yet that I should really post. Anyway, I don't remember who makes these, but they're fun little toys. So yeah, that's what I wanted to show you. Gavin Polis is saying, why is this episode called Goodbye Amiibos? It's called that because I'm packing them away, putting them away into boxes while I move. And I'm not going to see them for a while until my new house is all ready and all put together, my new office is put together, and then I'll be able to unbox them again and display them nicely. So that is why it's goodbye to the Amiibos for now. And let's see, what is Brian Flying or Dying saying? He says, are you going to do a stream of packing away your Mario and Sonic figures? I already packed away all my Mario figures, so no, I'm not going to do a stream of that. Sonic figures, I packed away most of them. I have a handful still out. I can even show you because I'm looking right at them. See, I got, there's the new Jak specific figures of Sonic, Tails, Shadow, and Robotnik that I have not packed up. There's packaged Sonic figures next to them. There's the new Mario and Yoshi that I just picked up today, so I gotta pack those up. And then above that, there are a bunch of Toy Island Sonic figures that I have not packed up yet. I gotta get to those too. So that is all that I haven't packed up yet. Maxwell is saying, how'd you feel about Min Min in Smash as the ARMS character for Smash Brothers Ultimate instead of Spring Man? Maxwell, I was totally fine with it. I really was. I would have been happy if it were Spring Man, because then I would have been right in my prediction video. But now I'm totally fine with Min Min. I think she's a fun character. It's just fine. And yeah, let's get to another amiibo, because I haven't done any in a while. Here we go. Here's the one I tripped over a minute ago. This is a 3-pack, and I don't know who this 3-pack is. Is because I didn't label it. Oh boy. Well, we know it's one of the more recent ones because it's got the red on it. Let's see. Oh, wait a second. I think this is the 3 Shovel Knight characters. Let's see. Let's see if King Knight fits in one of these. King Knight goes in the middle, doesn't he? That doesn't look right. That does not look right. What's another 3-pack that came recently? Let me know in the comments if you can think of another 3-pack that we've had recently. Where are the other Shovel Knight guys? Here we go. Here's Plague Knight. Is this where Plague Knight goes? No, this can't be Shovel Knight. Who is it? Goku Ketchum and Gabe the Wii Fan both say Octolings. Beta Whooper is better, saying maybe the Miis. I don't think it's the Miis, but it could be the Octolings. That was a good suggestion. Let's see. We'll try the Octopus Octoling. And that, I think that works, actually. Let's see. Where's the girl Octoling? I think she goes here. Is that right? No. Nope, that's got to be the spot for the boy Octoling. I think this is right. Where'd the girl Octoling go? Does this look right to you guys? Because the girl Octoling is just not fitting right. And it kind of had like a twist tie on it too. Which, yeah, I think this has got to be for the boy Octoling, right? Yeah. Yeah, that I think that's better. And girl Octoling. I don't know. I might have to come back to this one later because this is tough trying to just figure out how they all fit in here. But yeah, for those of you who suggested it's the Octolings box, you were correct. Yeah, definitely for Octolings. There we go. There, got them all fitting in. And there's that. Let's see, we'll just place them right there for now. Okay. What next? Oh, great. Another 3-pack. This one, I believe, is for the Shovel Knight characters. What's interesting of this one, this is pretty recent, but it looks like an older Amiibo type box. It doesn't have the newer red Nintendo logo, so. But here's Plague Knight, and I think he fits right in there. No? Am I wrong? Is that not for Plague Knight? That's gotta be for Plague Knight. And I think this is, that looks right for King Knight. And where's the third one? Here he is, got him. There we are. Got all 3 of them in. That one was much easier than the Octolings. All right. Got the Knights going. Whew! Fun stuff. Fun stuff. All right. Let's see who's next. Ivysaur, it says. Ivysaur. My IV is sore. Did I? I swear, I just got a new Ivysaur action figure from the Pokemon line of toys. And did I include that in my unboxing video? I don't think I did. I've got a whole video unboxing a whole bunch of Pokemon toys that I have not posted yet. I have not edited yet. Salvage Herald Skyline says, I think I'm going to sleep. Good night, Salvage Herald Skyline. Have a good night. Gavinopoulos says, are you excited for Banjo-Kazooie Amiibo? Yes, but I'm not crazy about his Smash Brothers pose, his Smash Brothers artwork. I mean, it's we have the Totaku. I'm gonna grab it right now. Here it is. Here's the Totaku figure of Banjo-Kazooie, which I think is just magnificent. I think he looks great. And I'm afraid his weird Smash Brothers picture of him, like, ooh, I don't know how good of an amiibo that's going to make. So we will see. We will see. You know, it might look amazing, honestly. It might put this Totaku figure to shame. I'm dusting it right now because it's a little dusty with this dusting rag. It's actually a Ninja Turtle Leonardo rag, in case you're wondering. But Devise Story 14 says, who's better, Conker or Banjo? Conker. Yep. And Danny Gamer Cool says, hi, Sonic Toast. Hello, Danny Gamer Cool. Good to see ya. Anyway, who's next? Who's next? Who's next? Maybe since we're talking about Totakus, we'll do another Totaku. This is Crash Bandicoot. This was one I also got on clearance back a few months ago, years ago, I don't remember. But yeah, I do like Crash Bandicoot, and I'm hoping he makes it into Smash. Because I'm so tired of all the, like, you know, serious anime-style Japanese characters from games I've never heard of joining Smash. And so I'm hoping we get another fun mascot character, such as Crash Bandicoot. I think he's a perfect candidate. I loved that we got Banjo-Kazooie as DLC. I love that we got Piranha Plant as DLC. And I just think we need more of these bright, fun, silly characters instead of just more and more anime-looking characters like that. So that's my two cents on that. Crash Bandicoot. All right, who will be next? Let's go with this one. Who could this be? Oh, wonderful. It's not labeled. I didn't label this one. Ooh, Arcel Martinez says, who's your first amiibo? My first amiibo. I remember going to Toys R Us the day they were released, and I had already pre-ordered Mario, so he was coming in the mail. But I bought Kirby for my son Kirby, Pikachu for my daughter Daisy. I bought Samus because she was shiny looking and looked cool. Oh, and Ness. Ness was also, I bought for my son Theodore because we all thought he looked like Ness at the time. He was just a little kid. So, yeah, I think, who else did I buy though? I bought Princess Peach that first day. I think I bought Donkey Kong. So yeah, I think that was it. I got Donkey Kong, Peach, Ness, Kirby, Pikachu, and Samus. I think I bought like six. So yeah, those were the first ones I got. And then Mario came in the mail later that week because I had pre-ordered him. And so, yeah. Looking at this, any idea who this could be? And it was an older one because it doesn't have the red on the package. Why did I not label this one? Who could that be? It looks like Dark Samus to me, but it can't be Dark Samus because Dark Samus would have the red packaging. I don't know. Well, I think we'll have to come back to this one. Big Whooper is better, saying maybe Pokemon. I don't know which Pokemon this would be. We'll come back to this one. Let's see. This one's not labeled either. It's a very weird looking one, though. We'll come back to that one, too. All right, let's see. This one's not labeled either. Who could this be? This is very oddly shaped. Huh. I wish I labeled these all. Hmm. That's a very wide one. Wait a second. Wait a second. I should know this because I look at this every single day. Because I work from home now, and right on my windowsill are these not amiibos. These are the Rabbids, Mario Rabbid figures that look like amiibos. They're the same size as amiibos, and sure enough, they're not amiibos. But yeah, this is the Rabbid Peach bubble. Huh, that took me a second to figure out. So there is that. Can I fit her back in? There we go. Rabbid Peach. Perfect. Why are these not amiibos? They so should have made these amiibos. Matter of fact, I gotta show you guys something. Where is it? Should be, there it is. All right, so this is an extra Mario that I have. Because when they made those Rabbid characters, I thought I would get a second Mario, second Yoshi, second Peach, and second Luigi. And I would cut the figure off and glue the Rabbids onto these and have my own Rabbid amiibos. So I started with Mario. I ordered this off eBay for cheap out of the package. And they sent it to me, and it had this on the bottom. Fuzziness for like Velcro or something like that, and I could not get it off, and that kind of ruined my whole plans of making Rabbid amiibos. So boy, he's dusty. Boy, he is dusty. So that's that. And yeah, that just makes me think of, for all these amiibos, I did keep the bubbles for all of them except for one, Princess Peach. So if I ever find a Peach in the wild, I might have to rebuy her just to have the bubble. Because, like I said, I bought her on day one, and I threw the bubble away. I threw the card away, the whole package and everything. I don't know why. I should have kept it. I think that's kind of my way of, when Amiibos came out, I didn't want to collect them all. I told myself, I'm only going to get the Mario characters. Then I said, I'll get the Mario characters and Samus because she's shiny looking. And I said, oh, but I got to get one for each of my kids. I had three kids at the time. And I said, so I got, you know, Pikachu for Daisy and Ness for Theodore and Kirby for Kirby. And so that's how I justified those. The next thing you know, I was like obsessed with Amiibos, buying them all. Like, here's this. This is like, this box is where I keep a lot of their cards. The backs of the amiibo packages. You see, this is where I keep their cards in here. Of course, this is only ones that fit in here. I have a whole big old box just full of the cards. And I have them all except for Princess Peach. Hers is the only card I did not keep. And I deeply regret it to this day. I do. Anyway, I'm trying to fit these back in the box now because I pulled out two of them. And now I'm trying to figure out how to get them back in there. Let's see. There. Fit it in. Okay. Whew. Let's see. I'll take some more of your comments now. Let's see, Minnowman 9000 Yo-Yo Reviews says, I love Min Min, she is super pretty with her green eyes. Oh my gosh, I just love her so much. I can't even explain how much I love her. She is super, super cute, LOL. Okay, thank you for sharing your love for Min Min. Very nice. Mikey S says, have you watched Friends? I have never seen Friends. I really haven't. Should I watch it? Let me know in the comments. Yeah, like when I was a kid, Friends was very popular, but I was just a little kid, and it's not really a little kid show, so I never really got into it. Let's see, have you ever played any Sonic fan games, says Osvaldo Lemus. Sonic fan games, And you're not counting Sonic Mania, right? I've played mods of Sonic games, like a lot of those Sonic 1 mods where you can play as Kirby or Princess Sally or Pikachu or Amy Rose. I've played a lot of those. And the Sonic Generations mods where you can play as Mario and Luigi. I love those. I think that's the closest thing I've played to Sonic fan games. Gail Ramirez says, "Did you watch The Mandalorian?" Yeah, loved it. Everyone loves it. It's great. I even got the Baby Yoda Funko Pop, like the giant Baby Yoda Funko Pop. His ears just go on for miles. And let's see. Let's take another comment. "What about Sonic 2 XL? It's that game where Sonic gets fat," says JL Studios. Oh yeah, I did play that. Wow, that was like what, 10 years ago? I played that one. Yeah, I didn't find it very fun though, because as soon as you just get some rings, you turn fat and you can't play anymore. This is my Ant-Man cup. Got it when I saw Infinity War. Gotta stay hydrated. All right, let's see here. Let's box up another amiibo. I gotta find a box that actually is labeled. Did we look at this one already? This is. Dang it, this one's not labeled. Why? I must have like gone through a phase where I didn't label them. And this one's so weird looking. It's like a big letter Y. Let me know in the comments if you know who this one is. Oh wait. I think I might know who this one is. Is it this guy of a what's his name? Something of Astora. There, look, fits perfect. Perfect. What's his name again? Solaire. Thank you, Goku Ketchum. Solaire of Astora. Yes, and DREC said it also, and so did DBay X Schiff, Japanese symbols. Eddie the Legend says, "Hey, Sonic Toast, who do you want to see as a Super Smash Bros. U Ultimate DLC from the Sonic franchise? I really want to see Tails or Metal Sonic." I want to see anyone from the Sonic franchise at this point. I feel like Sonic has been pretty snubbed in this game. And yeah, I mean, Street Fighter got a second rep. Castlevania got a second rep. And when it comes to third-party characters, I feel like Tails and Knuckles and Robotnik are more household names than a majority of the Smash Brothers characters. I mean, yeah, everybody knows Pikachu, everybody knows Mario, Luigi, Peach, and all of Mario's cast, but like nobody knows who Byleth is or Joker. You know, when you hear Joker, everyone thinks of the Batman villain. So yeah, I just really feel like Sonic's characters are very, very popular, and they should really be in Smash Brothers. And that's just not just coming from me as a Sonic fan. As a video game fan as a whole, I feel like Sonic's characters are more important than they're getting credit for. Let's see. Sonic Lego 11223344 says, "Have you played Sonic and the Black Knight?" Yeah. You know, when that came out, I loved Sonic and the Black Knight. I thought it was a lot of fun. Who was it? Fighting Shadow, I think the second time I hated that fight. Yeah, I just felt like Sonic and the Black Knight was good, but it went too long. I felt the game was too long because after you beat the main story and get the credits and everything, there were still like more levels to do, and that's where I stopped. But you know, for the initial game, I did enjoy that, the Sonic and the Black Knight. Anyway, let's move on to another amiibo. Let's see who this one is. Yes, this one's labeled. It's Squirtle. Good. Wow. So we've already packed up the Pokemon trainer and Ivysaur and now Squirtle. However, I don't think Charizard's package is anywhere near these ones because the Charizard amiibo is much older than these ones. I love the modern amiibos. I think they look so good. All right. There's Squirtle. Who will be next? How about this one? Oh, here we go. Another Totaku. Sonic Totaku. Let's pull him over. All right. Just pulled over a handful of Totakus, including little Squirrel, Conker. All right. I think I like the Sonic Totaku figure better than even the Sonic Amiibo. Alright, Sonic Kotaku. Here we go. You know, the Tails Kotaku. If anyone saw my Kotaku unboxing video the first time when we did Sonic Tails and Knuckles, and I opened the Tails one, and he snapped straight out of the box. Just the little clear pole that he sits on just snapped. I took that one back to GameStop. And I wanted to return it, of course, and get one, and it wasn't broken. They didn't want to do they didn't want to let me return it, the broken one. And I actually told them, well, I've got a YouTube video showing it snapping straight out of the box. And then they said, okay, fine, fine, we'll do the exchange. So that was nice of them. And that's why there's two unboxing videos of two Kotaku Tails. I remember when I did the second one, there's comments saying, haven't we seen this already? Anyway, yeah, so there is Kotaku Sonic. Where are we gonna put him? Oh, I don't wanna stack these too high, honestly. Let me move these Mario characters. And we'll put Kotaku Sonic right there. Alrighty. Whew, here we go. Moving right along. Well, speaking of Kotaku Tails, here's his package. Let's get him in. I just saw an interesting comment actually from DaREC. If you could live with one character not existing, any character in fiction, who would it be? Okay, that's actually a really easy question. The one character I would remove from existence would be Robecca. Robecca. Does anyone know who that is? Comment right now. I don't know, there might be lag or something. DREC says yes. Device Story 14 says yes. Let's see. I Like Coconuts says I don't know who that is. Device Story 14 says Sat-Am. Yep, that is from Saturday Morning Sonic. DRE says, from one of the Sonic shows. I don't remember though. Don't know who she is. Says ramen noodles are good. All right. Well, yep. And Goku Ketchum says, Sat-Am. So, Sat-Am Sonic had one episode that was just horrible, where Rotor makes this stupid robot called Robecca. And she falls in love with Antoine, and the whole episode is just long and boring of her chasing Antoine through the forest so she can hug him and kiss him. And it was just awful, awful. And you can imagine being a kid when that episode came out in like 94, I think, waiting all week for a new episode of Sonic and getting that. That was yeah. There's still the stain on my childhood. As a matter of fact, I think when they were releasing like rant DVDs of like random episodes, I think they skipped that one. But it is in the full series DVD set. Yeah. Ugh, I think the second character I would delete from existence would be Queen of the Merhogs from Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog. Yeah. Myrna the Merhog was the female mermaid hedgehog girl that Sonic had a crush on in that episode. And then there was the Queen of the Merhogs that was just ugh. Just thinking of the character just makes me nauseated. So yeah, she would be number two. The only thing is the Queen of the Merhogs, she didn't ruin the episode the way Robecca ruined her episode, but she's still just an unpleasant character. Oh, French bears. I just wasn't thinking why I put tails in here, and the pole looks like it's bending. Come on, don't break, don't break. Okay. French bears. I think he looks okay. Yeah. It just looks a little bit off. Fragile. Fragile. Fragile figure. All right. I'm just glad I didn't snap it again. Okay, so there's Tails Totaku. If I can fit him into this little container. Okay. There. Tails Totaku. Alright, we'll put him next to Sonic. He won't stay up. There. Sorry, he's covering up Incineroar, so Incineroar fans, I do apologize. Anyway, fun stuff going on here, friends. Fun stuff. I look forward to the future as I'm going to be getting a new house soon. It was just time for an upgrade. It was time for an upgrade in homes because my kids, I have four kids, and they're just getting bigger and bigger. And then I remarried at the end of February. So my new wife moved in and her son moved in. So now I have five kids. And we just outgrew this this little house, so we've had a lot of fun memories here. So yeah, it's and a lot of those memories have been making videos, of course, making all these Amiibo videos, and it's been a lot of fun. I'm really happy for just the time I've been able to spend in this house. And I just think it's been a lot of fun, and I want to thank everyone who's been on board for all these years, whether you've been here for 12 years or whether you've been here for a week. It's been a good time. Remember when we did a Sonic plushie video and Super Sonic was beating up all the other plushies? that was a fun one. And there's the over here, there's the Sonic Ducks. Those were some fun, some DuckTales. Woo! Because Tails is a duck. Oh boy, all the memories. Down here, Mario cereal boxes. And up here, Sonic, Pac-Man, and Mega Man cereal boxes. Remember when we were eating those, trying them on the spot? Oh, fun stuff. And, how about Daily Toast? Anyone here remember Daily Toast, where we would talk about a different Mario or Sonic game every day of the week? And that went on for a year. Oh, that had me really tired after doing that for a whole year. Oh, fun stuff, fun stuff. And anything else? There's my Virtual Boy up there. Donkey Kong, large figure. Yep, things were good. There's Jazzwares Sonic hanging out in the closet there. Oh, fun stuff, fun stuff. So, friends, thank you for being here. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it off because I'm feeling really tired, but I do appreciate y'all just spending your evening with me. Boxing up these Amiibos. Looks like we got a few done. Oh, still got so many more to go. So many. But oh well. And yeah, sorry, I won't be making a ton of videos for the next week or so. I was just working on packing and moving and then unpacking, and it's going to be busy. But I'll try to do what I can. I don't know if anyone here likes watching my Sonic Dash playthroughs, but they did just put out a new Sonic Dash character, so I'll try to do a playthrough of that new character this weekend, probably tomorrow. It's Special Agent Rouge, so that's important because Rouge the Bat is now the only character in Sonic Dash to get two alternate costumes, because we had Witch Rouge from Halloween, and now it's like Super Special Secret Agent Rouge, where she's wearing like a DBZ scouter and like a black secret agent outfit. So that's interesting. I wonder what they're gonna do with Tails, because Tails doesn't have an alternate outfit in Sonic Forces Speed Battle or in Sonic Dash yet, but I'm betting they're gonna do Tails soon, because they just did Treasure Hunting Knuckles, and Treasure Knuckles hasn't had an alternate outfit until now, so that's interesting there. Anyway, so that's my little rant about that. Friends, have a wonderful evening. Thanks again for being here, and toast.